I basically did not like see the fantasy people build behind USC after coming back home. So let's like rewind. Hello, hi you guys. Hello. Welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, I'm Akanksha. Can you see where I am? I am back home. I'm back in my studio. I'm back home. I'm back in Hyderabad. I'm back in India. Oh my god, it's been a while. I really, really miss this. It's really good to sit down and talk to you guys from where I'm actually more comfortable with. I know I did videos in, you know, while I was away as well, but this is just some another kind of comfort, and I'm so glad and so happy to be back. I have a lot of content planned for you guys. I know I've been inconsistent. First of all, yeah, let me start with an apology. And more than, you know, you guys, I know it is really annoying that I was not consistent, but it is more annoying to me myself because I felt so guilty for doing it. I will also get into why I was inconsistent, etc., etc. But apart from whatever excuses I do have, I am actually really sorry for being inconsistent. I really am going to get back. I have a lot of content planned for the next few weeks, which I'm super excited to execute. I know I've just been doing a lot of vlogs, so I'm going to try to balance both because sit down videos are like, you know, the OG. I love doing them. So yeah, that being said, now let's get into the video. I just want to sit and talk before I get into another content like makeup reviews or fashion videos or whatever it is we do. I just wanted to, like, you know, first sit and give a life update and talk about what happened, what is going on, tell you what happened in the US, and answer your questions. I put a question on Instagram as well. So yeah, a lot of things to talk about, and I'm sure this video is going to be pretty long because it's been such a long time. I like sat and told you what is happening, and I don't think I can finish everything in one video. I want to do story times as well of a lot of things I've done in the US, so I'm going to try to fit few things here. We'll do few things later. So anyways, my intros are so long. Anyways, let's get into the video and we'll talk and do some makeup. Skin though, I was like, touch wood, it was doing well once I came back. It's been a couple of weeks I came back, you guys, but it has no reason to break out. It just randomly does, and it's so stubborn. The acne scars are so stubborn. It takes months and months for them to go away. I don't even, not even around periods. Am I, what is the date? No, I don't have for another 10 days. And why it's so super annoying. But anyways, let's get into the makeup. Let's start off with US. It was nice, you guys. Like I think everybody has New York as a bucket list for traveling, and I'm so glad I did New York, I did Miami. So there were four things I planned for sure. I really want to go when I am in US is New York, Florida, like Miami, LA, and Las Vegas. These four I was like, I want to really cover. Like I had Chicago etc in mind, but these four were like, I have to go. But what happened is I went to the US and I was there like for a month, and then during like Christmas and New Year, a lot of COVID cases started coming up. So again, it was like a third wave, although nobody literally cares in the US about the, you know, COVID. Like nobody was wearing masks. Like masks also were not a mandate. Like nobody was quarantining, like nothing. There was no restrictions whatsoever. But being in India, we were like, you know, so precautious about this stuff all the time. We were, you know, yeah, we were like a lot precautious compared to people in the West, right? And that was deeply like in my head, and I did not like, I willfully did not feel like traveling anywhere. And like, everybody was like, you know, it's not a big deal, like, you know, all of them stay there, for them it is a very normal thing to just travel like that. But for us, because we had restrictions, we controlled ourselves from traveling for a while, I was like, you know, it does not seem right to for me to travel when like there are 1 million cases in a day, you know. And I do not basically want to risk it as well. I'm there in the I don't know, like I did have insurance, but still, like I'm there, I'm not in my country. Imagine if something happens, nobody's there to take care of me. So I do not want to go anywhere where I had to basically travel by flight. Long story short, basically I could not do LA and Vegas because of the third wave and my own self-restrictions. And I probably would have done, I actually cut down my trip, yeah, that is also there. So I was supposed to come back Feb ending, but then I came back Jan ending because I was too homesick and there were a lot of things happening here which I could not leave and I wanted to come back. So I cut my trip short. Probably if I stayed for, like, you know, the next 3 weeks, I would have got, imagine how unlucky. Oh my god, this was the worst thing. The only thing I regretted coming back early is because, like, literally the day or 2-3 days after I landed, I got an invitation for like New York Fashion Week, and I was so upset. Like, literally tomorrow, day after, was Fashion Week, and they informed like 2 days before that can Akanksha attend the Fashion Week. And I'm like, you could have told me 1 week earlier. Like, even if you told me 2 days earlier, I probably would have stayed, attended New York Fashion Week, because it's not something which you get always, right? Especially because I was there and they gave me that opportunity, and I regret it so damn much. But you know, it is what it is. That's the, like, only time I regretted, ki shit, dude, I should have stayed for 3-4 more weeks and I could have attended Fashion Week. But irrespective, like, I was so happy being back home. So US was good and all. I want to say so many things, but again, I'm like, it's an open platform, right? Anybody can see. But this is just like my, my experience and how it was for me. I to answer the main question, because this question, literally everybody, once I come back, is asking everyone. I mean, obviously, I did go to US and come back. So everybody's like, Amrika Nachinda, like, you know, did you like the US? How was it? Did you enjoy and all? And for everybody, my answer is like, yeah, I liked it. I mean, I did like it. It's good for traveling. There are amazing places. There's an amazing lifestyle. You can go see, have fun. I was there for two and a half months, and I was like, whenever I was traveling, I was super happy. I, like, you know, did whatever I wanted to do, and it was really nice. But other than that, like, when I was at home in Tampa, I was like, it's not boredom, it's just like I didn't feel like I belong there. And I always knew, even I know now as well, that I don't see myself living anywhere else except India. It has become home now. Probably even I would love to go somewhere, but I would definitely come back to India again. So I knew that always, but after going there, I understood it so much more. If you're going to travel and come back, it's like a temporary thing. But I literally, like, uprooted my life and went there for 2 months. And my sole reason was going for, was because of my sister, that I wanted to go stay with her, because it's been 5 years that she had come. But what, like, I did not anticipate getting this homesick or like missing my people so much. I thought it's just like a matter of 3 or 4 months. I'll just go, come back. But you know, there's a certain sense of feeling of home when you are with certain people, right? And I was missing my people so much, because I could not, like, you know, at the end of the day, there I only had my sister who I could completely rely on, like my family, right? So I completely could only rely on her. But if you're like relying or being with just one person for continuously every single minute for like 2-3 months, you kind of like get annoyed by them also, right? That's a very normal thing to happen when you have like your life plus like somebody together. That's like a different thing to have. So for me, like, it was my sister, and I do not have, other than that, any other life than that. She had friends, like I met them, like I was living with few of them. We went out and all, but at the end of the day, they're not my friends, and they're still my sister's friends. And I did not get that close to them that I could call them my close friends, or I was comfortable enough with them. I'm a person, I do not open up easily. I do not let people in easily. And so, like, first time when someone sees me, they always be like, I'm a bitch. Like, it's not that I want to be, but the way I talk or the way I say things, I don't intend to be that, but a lot of people cannot take the way I talk. So initially, like, whenever anybody like meets me or sees me, they'll be like, you know, she's such a bitch, or she, you know, it's like all the friends I have right now, like my closest set of friends, everybody said the same thing to me first. Like, everybody in the first, they were like, you know, let's not talk to her. But then now they know me, and then they are like, you're the least, you know, bitchy person I know. So it's like that, and I never minded that because I know, like, once they talk to me, they get to know me, it changes. But that never happened there. And it's like, you know, you're meeting new people so often, so frequently. At one point, you're like, I'm done with this, right? Like, you, and firstly, I'm a more like ambivert introvert, so my personality really depends upon the people around me. And I, like, as a person, like, my first instinct is not to go socialize. It does not come to me naturally. But then I was there, I was meeting so many new people, I had to, like, hang out with new people. And as far as you hang out, like, in groups, you can never get close to people, right? Because it's like, when you're a group, it's like a very, like, superficial fun. You have fun, you're just, like, hanging out, and it's good, and it's fine, like, that's fine. But for you to, like, get to know a person, at least the way I bond with people is when I sit and talk. Like, I can talk for hours, and I can listen to somebody talk for hours, and that's the way I bond with people. Like, that's how you generally get to know people only, right? Like, if you talk, if you tell things, that's how you understand the person in front as well. And if I share, and that's how they'll understand. But then that was not happening there. So because it was only like, you know, we're hanging out in groups, so nobody, like, really knows me or knows the good side of me. They just know, like, superficially. And that's the same thing which happens the other side. But one thing which happens with me is I'm very short-tempered. I don't like show that anger on everybody, but it does come out, like, with my family. So whenever I do get angry, I was getting angry on my sister and people around me, or, like, anybody who sees it, it's like they don't see, like, see, everybody has, like, I don't know why I'm tearing up, because it kind of did affect me a lot. Like, the entire time I was in US, like, it was, I could, like, show it to be, like, a very fantasy life or everything, but I honestly had, like, a really rough time mentally while I was there. And that is what I realized after coming back home. So let's, like, rewind. This will look so stupid. It'll be like she had so much luxury to go to US, have such a nice time, and then now she's coming and crying. But just, you know, keep an open mind. I'll tell you, like, I have no regrets. I know I'm so lucky. I know I went there. I know it was amazing. But I just did not want to, like, glorify the entire thing. And in my mind, I constantly have this thing, even when I have to post or do something, I'm like, I don't want to, like, fantasize my life and make somebody feel bad that, you know, they don't have a life like that. So I'm just going to, like, you know, it's just me trying to share what actually happened. And, like, the good side is obviously what you see, the bad side is something you don't see. So I just thought, like, I'll share the bad side with you guys. So anyways, basically every person has a good side and a bad side, and it's a common thing, everybody has that. But when you know the good side, the bad side is really easy to ignore. Like, bad side, when I say, like, you have arguments, or, like, you know, you get angry, you get, you know, there's things which happen, like, when especially when you're living with people, it kind of happens, and it's very normal. And in our house, like, everybody is short-tempered, so for us it's kind of common to lose our temper. And I know it's not easy for outside people to see that temper and be like, it's normal. But when they know me, they know the good side of me, they see this, and it's like they know that it's just, like, a thing for a minute or five, and then it's done. But then that thing people around, like, don't know. And I know people say, like, you should not care what other people think or, like, anything, but when you're constantly in that zone where, first of all, people already assume you to be, like, a bitch and etc., and then you shout or you do something, they're like, I don't know, it automatically, like, kind of makes you look like a bad person. And I hated that feeling, because because of that feeling, I actually kind of try to sit down and, like, you know, tell people things, to know them, to get to know me. So that I generally never do that. Even when I was telling this to my friends, she's like, you made an effort to, like, sit and talk to people, that's, like, a huge thing. Because I generally don't do that, like, I keep to myself, and if it's my people, I talk, or else I don't talk. It's like, I'm not that person who lets other people in as well. But when I was living there, I was like, okay, this is my life now, and I do, like, kind of have to stay here for some time, I need to do this. So I was trying to sit and talk, like, when you don't get the reciprocation back, you're like, how much will I also talk, right? So it's like I was trying to show, like, you know, I'm not a bad person. I don't even know if the other person was, like, feeling like that, but it constantly happens. And I was just feeling like I'm a horrible human being, and I was just not able to accept that. Like, I literally was craving for my people. Like, I need my people around where I don't have to constantly be cautious about what I'm saying, or constantly, like, be like worried that what other people might be thinking. Or it's always that constant, like, even it's around your people, you know. See, you go socialize with other people, you kind of like either drain out, especially when it's like new people, but then once, like, you know, you come home, you recharge, and then you're like, okay, fine, you know, that was just like something I did there and it's over. But when you constantly like keep doing it and you don't have a safe space to go, or you have don't have your people to go out and balance that thing, it just keeps getting too much, because you're always in this uncomfortable zone, in this new zone, and it's happening like for such a long period of time. Like, when I was on vacations, I was like so happy all the time, but whenever there is like new people involved or something and something happening, I'm like, it's not my piece of cake. So I basically, that and like so many other things, I was just feeling like a horrible human being, and I could not take it, because being good is something which kind of plays a huge important role, and I could not accept the fact that people probably are thinking that I am a horrible human being, despite like how much you can, no matter how much you train yourself not to care about what other people think, you still are that around it, you're in that atmosphere, like you're not getting your people vibe, you're not getting that comfort, you know, it does bother you. I don't know, I felt very like disrespected in a way. I felt like, you know, a lot of people made me feel like, I personally can understand why they kind of feel that way, because I know, I don't know anybody my age who went there, lived for like 2-3 months, you know, did whatever she wanted to do with her own money, because like I don't think any of them like have seen like that. Usually like parents go when the, you know, for children wagera, but like people my age, usually they don't even get visa for traveling. But luckily, touch wood, I got it for a few years ago and I utilized it now. So like, I don't know why, so a lot of people don't even know what I do, and even if they do, it's like more like a very judgmental thing somehow, and then they make me feel like I'm a spoiled daddy's rich girl. I don't know, it could just be in my head and nobody even thought that, but I was just getting all these vibes altogether. And for me to be disrespected, it's such a huge thing. I don't like, if it's like, if there's a little bit of disrespect, I just walk away from that place. I'm like, I'm not even dealing with you, I don't want you. If you can't respect another person, I can't, like, you know, deal with you at all. And for me to like go there and then they don't even know what I do, they don't even know how, like, my career or what I do, and then they just try to, like, I have not took a penny from my house in over 2 years now since I started doing this, but for me to go there and people judge me, like, you know, oh, you're just wasting money, or oh, you're just I don't know, like, you know, that spoiled rich daddy's girl kind of vibe. Like, back when I was actually taking from my dad, I did not spend anything at all, because my dad always put a limit on our thing, and I was not at all like in a luxury or like I spend extravagantly. I earn now, I had a certain set of money I put aside just for US, and I was doing it, but then people just like assume few things and it just kind of bothers you so much. So like so many things like this kept happening again and again, and I could not just, like, you know, take it. So I was in a very like fucked up mental space, and at one point I was like, I just need to go home now, it's too much, I just need to come back. I have a lot of things to do, I miss my friends, I miss home, I miss Pravalika, I want to like just go back. And even I was not able to work properly, because, you know, work as in, like, you know, making videos and all, if I was still in like a good mental state, I could have done it. But when it comes to like brand deals, etc., so what happens when it's like brand deals, like majority of the brands or agencies wake up so last minute, so 70% of the work happens in like in a week. So if I was in US for them to send me products or do anything, it would take 1 week, right? So if I'm at home, like if today is you know, they'll call me and be like, we need the video, like today, if it's Sunday, they'll be like, I need the video by Friday, and we can still make it happen, because mostly I usually do have products, or else they'll just ship it overnight, I'll get it on Monday, then I'll have 2-3 days to shoot and I'll give it by Friday. But in US, imagine, it takes me like 5 days to get it. So most of the campaigns were not even happening because I was away. So I was like, you know, why am I even staying here, feeling so bad, like, you know, neglecting my work and still feeling so shitty, it's not worth it. So I was like, fuck it, I'll just come back home. I can go back again some other time. I can go back, see things. It's not worth it to just like, you know, stay for this time. It's not like I did not have a good time. There were good times as well. I had an amazing time. Like my trips. Oh my God, New York is something I will never. I think I should like literally make a separate video for New York to just sit and talk to you guys about the stories, because I was there alone. So I was there for like 12 days, 8 days I was by myself, 4 days I had like my sister and her friends. So imagine, I have so many stories and so many experiences I had in New York, which I will always cherish. It was my first solo trip and it was in New York, and I like had a ball, like literally a ball. I had so much fun in New York. But then like there were lot of bad days and I could not like kind of keep up with filming. I was just like not in the zone. I had no creativity whatsoever. I had no ideas, no mind to do anything at all. And it's like I also really loved like New York and Miami for one reason, is that so I'm as a person, I'm a very like independent person in a sense, especially like for doing things. Okay, the only people I depend on like completely in a very bad way is like my family. Kind of spoils me, like my mom and my sister, my dad, like all these people are the only people I can take help from, and they will give even without asking me because they're family and they know I'm super spoiled that way. Okay, but then if it comes to outside people or anytime, even my bestest friends, I'm not that person. I don't like asking for help or I don't like taking help. But there I had to like, you know, depend on someone or the other for everything. Like if I want to go get groceries, if I want to go out, if I want to do anything, it was always like somebody I had to like depend on. And I'm so not used to it at all whatsoever. I'm so used to doing things by my own, but there I was not as independent again in like, you know, an everyday thing. I'm not talking about financial independence or like emotional independence, like doing everyday things. I'm not used to having somebody always around, and there like I always had to ask somebody for things. And it does not matter. Probably the person in front is not even thinking like, oh, I need to help her. And it might be the sweetest people. And I'm sure I don't think anybody minded as well. But me, as how I am as a person, I just felt like I was being a burden. And I just don't like other people doing things for me. I'm just so used to doing it for myself. I just like, you know, felt like so powerless also in a way, that I was not able to do whatever I want to do. The life I have here is such a comfortable life. I know I like luxury, I know I like nice things, so I've made my life that way. And I know this place so well, that India, I can do wherever I go, I can like figure shit out and I can do whatever I want to do. But there it is not like that. It's like a new place. And I just felt so powerless in a way. Not powerless like to do something, but powerless like my life is not in my hands. It's like not in my control, and I cannot take that fact. Like being powerless for one day probably would be fine, but for like two and a half months for the person I am. So all this might be very small things for like different people, because everybody has like a different personality. But for me as a person, or as how I am, like if people outside who know me, like then if I tell this, they'll completely understand, because they know how like, you know, self Atmanirbhar I am in like a lot of things. So it was just like I was feeling so powerless. I was feeling like, I don't know, like, you know, I have a beautiful life here and I was missing it so much. Something was happening with my friend here and I was like, you know what, fuck it, let me just like go back home. I am done, it's okay, I can come back. And so that's the reason I am back in India, and I'm so happy and I'm so glad. I don't even regret once, except for the New York Fashion Week, that I came back early. But yeah, I'm happy, I'm home, I have a lot of things planned. I had to like push myself, force myself, and like, you know, do videos also where like, you know, like brand videos where I had to give those things. I pushed myself to do, and sometimes then I was like, you know, okay, I'm gonna film a few videos here and there. But I had so much planned for US. That the only thing, yeah, I regret is that I couldn't. I had so much content in mind which I wanted to do in US, because you know that specifically I could have done that. It would have been so much more fun, but I was not able to do that. It's the only thing I regret, that I could have used that opportunity so much more. It's such a good opportunity for a creator to go there, because you know there's so much content you can make, but I could not. And it's so sad. I hated that my mental health kind of relates to my work so much. Even in India, a lot of people, like when they're sad, they kind of put all that energy routine to work. But for me, it's like, it's 50-50. Sometimes it just makes me escape properly. But there are a few days where I cannot, like when I'm in that zone, I cannot put, even if I do it, the outcome is usually bad. So yeah, anyways. Whew, my base is done. But I'm so happy that I did go to US because it's an experience not everybody can have, and I really like that I went, and this was such a proper time in my life for me to go, because at this point of my life I did not have like anything holding me back. Like in future I don't know what it would be like, you know, I do not have a business, like a physical business. This is something I did there as well, but I do not have any business holding me back or like a pet holding me back. It was like also the right time for me to go, in a sense. It's also because my sister also had work from home, so a few more months they'll have as well. But if I went another time, she would have been in office, I would have been at home, and I would have got bored also. But this time, like, you know, there were people at home always, so it was like kind of fun to be around as well. So, you know, it was like proper time for me to go, and I'm so grateful I went, and like, you know, I did what I wanted to. And then but going there, you also like kind of see so many different things. Like, oh my god, firstly, mainly when we watch like television shows and all, you don't, like, you know about racism when people are talking about it, but you don't know how you know, evident it is. But going there, I kind of witnessed how strong and how evident like racism is among people. On TV shows and all, it's like you just see a part of it, you don't really know it. But after going there, you kind of like know and see so many things always, and it's like it kind of, you know, can't accept it. It's so gross, but it's so common there. So, and like, no wonder people fight so much for race, because the inequality is it's there, it's so common, and it really really does need to change. So everybody has been asking me one thing, like, what did you like, do you like US better than India? Everybody like fantasizes America so much, It is a country full of opportunities. Yes, of course, it's a country full of life. But I did not see anything different for me, which I did not have in India there. Like, I have whatever I needed, like whatever I had in US, I had in India. So I did not see a lifestyle different. Like, India actually changed a lot in the last 5 years. So people who went before that, I can completely understand when they say, like, you know, there's nothing in India. But like, I've seen everything here. Like, I've seen how life can be. I mean, again, mine could be coming from a very privileged standpoint, I understand that, but for me, that's why I'm saying, for me, I did not see anything different for myself in the US compared to India, except for roads. Everybody, I'm telling this, like, what did you like in US that India does not have? I'm like, roads, dude. Like, the only thing, the roads and the traffic, if India had, I would have been like, there's nothing like India does not have, you know. So whenever I say roads, everybody like kind of laughs, but that is true. But also, India has so much population, dude. Like, US is so big and the population is so much, and India is so much and the population is so much. And I kind of like understand the whole thing as well, but I just like funnily say, if India just had the roads, I wouldn't, like, you know, it is no different than US for me. I don't see myself living there for sure. Maybe like I can go there for studying. I basically did not like see the fantasy people build behind US. The only people who've gone there actually know the reality of what happens there. This is only the perspective from what I have seen. I could totally be wrong. There are a lot of people who might be like having a beautiful, wonderful, another different lifestyle, which I have not seen. From my perspective, like, it's just glorified because it's USA. And but there's literally, after you go there, you have to work your ass off. It's not easy. It's a very expensive place, unless you have rich parents or who can, like, you know, send you like 3 lakhs a month for you when you're in college. You cannot have fun, like, you do part time, you do shit, and it's so stressful constantly for them, because I've seen them, like, the visa issues or the job issues or financial issues. It is not as glorified. I don't know why even people now till date, like, they just want to push their kids. Like, everybody, like, I feel like everybody around me, like, wedding, studies or whatever it is, they want to send their children to the USA. And I'm like, if you have little bit of brain and if you can use it in India, you have beautiful opportunities in India as well, especially like these aunties, uncles, and among parents, it's so much more glorified, but they do not actually see the reality. After like, you know, going there, it's still just assumed like US hai to acha hai. Like they'll be like, you know, he's earning 4-5 lakhs, 5-6 lakhs is a lot of amount for our people. That is true. But 5-6 lakhs is a lot of amount. If you're in India, if you're in US, 5-6 lakhs is not a great amount. It's like you're earning like 1 lakh or 2 lakhs in India. They don't see the cost of living, that it is so much more expensive than it is in India. It's not like they're getting sabzi for like 30 rupees, right? They'll get sabzi for like $30, and that's what, 3000 rupees. So the cost of living is obviously like so much different, which they don't really understand. But if I do explain, they'll be like, and they, you know, sometimes you're just like stubborn enough to not see the reality, right? Like you're just in denial, you just want to believe what you know, and you don't want to see the reality. So I'm like, I don't even tell anybody now. But that's what I feel like, it's not as glorified, the life is not glorified if you do plan on going, and if you want to go to masters. Like you'll of course learn life for sure going away from home. You'll become so much more independent, you'll know how to live, that's amazing. All those factors are definitely there, but I'm just telling in that perspective that of parents, like what they have in mind, like what generally society has in mind. Oh, like, you know, his son went to US, oh, his daughter went to US, like they have this and they glorify it so much. Everybody wants to push their kids there, but it's not as easy, it's not as simple. A lot of people do have a good life, whoever went there. It's, you know, just my perspective. Like, I mean, it could be totally that, because this is doing what I do, works for me here. I cannot like see that life there, so that could also be the whole thing. Just again, my perspective. I don't want to like offend anybody. If you have like a really beautiful life in USA, please continue it. It's not just as good and glorified as people make it. You will miss home, you will be away from your people, you'll have so many different things. It's always like, yes, good to learn, good to grow, but I'm just saying, don't expect like some fancy fairy tales and like, you know, go there. It's not going to be that. Anyways, now that I'm back home, I have so much content in mind which I want to push out. First thing when I came back, I'm like, oh my god, my studio is back, I have my own lights, I have my everything set up, I have like an entire room to do whatever I want to do. My sister, poor thing, bought everything for me. Like she bought lights, she bought you know, tripod, she bought everything. But you know, my studio is my studio, right? So I'm just like more comfortable, and I'm like, it feels like home, baby. I'm also thinking of starting shout outs. This has been in my mind for so many years, like since 2 years, like when I started YouTube, I wanted to do this, but for some reason I always postponed because I did not get like the right name for my, like, you know, followers, and I was like, never mind. But all at this point I still don't have a name, but I know a lot of you guys support me, and it is so sweet, especially when you send me DMs. My heart just go like, oh my god, I don't deserve this. So I wanted to like, you know, give a shout out to everybody. So in the comments, you can, whenever you're commenting, just write like hashtag like AKS, and also suggest me a name in the comments if you have something nice, like, you know, for like somebody said AK Army, like Akanksha Army, but that's so, I don't know, I can't accept it. I cannot call you guys Army or whatever it is, it's too much. It's just like, you know, something cute, maybe aligns with Akanksha or something. I know you guys are creative, come up with it. But for now, if you do want a shout out, then comment something and use the hashtag AKS, and I will give you guys a shout out in every video. So now I'll just answer a few questions you guys have for me. Okay, somebody asked, I don't know how people are still not having clarity. I've mentioned this a lot of times. So in US, you're younger one. So we are three sisters. One is Pravalika, who's differently abled. You see in my vlogs here and there. She is the elder one. Then there is another sister who is in the US. You've seen her in the vlogs. Her name is Hashita. So, and I am the youngest one. I know I look older than my other sisters, and people usually assume I'm the older one, but no, I'm the younger one, and I have two elder sisters. What are your plans in future regarding education? I don't know why I have this very bad urge to actually do something like studying wise abroad or like here. I don't know. I did undergraduation, I did not do post graduation, so I really want to, but I don't know when. If I do, I'll do it only in a time where colleges are open and I can physically go to college, because I'm not going to sit at home and get a degree. If I'm going to college, it's mainly because of the college life, and I am not just like, you know, sitting back and not having that. What job Pravlika do? What job will she do? All she does is eat and sleep and irritate my mom. That's it. But what will she do, you guys? I think maybe she meant to ask what job my other sister does. She's a software employee. So she did her master's in the US and she's been there ever since. Point of motivation to get serious on work, to make money. Really, that's the best motivation, to have a big bank balance is my motivation to work. Okay, very interesting question. Do you find your interest shifting from what you do currently? Yes, I do want to, like, you know, more explore more different types of content as well, because I've been doing this for years and I'm very comfortable with this. This is my zone, but I do want to, like, as a creator, explore more options, probably bring in a team where they could help me execute a lot of ideas which I cannot do by myself. All my videos, every single one of them which I've done till date, I have filmed by myself. I had no help, I had no editor, I had no videographer, I have nothing. I've always done things by myself. So when you do that, you kind of limit yourself also in a certain way, like creatively, because you know you can't like move the camera and move yourself at the same time, right? So in that way, I do want to, like, you know, explore more and create more in that perspective, because now, like, financially, touch wood, I can afford, like, you know, to bring in people and like help them bring my vision to place. And also, like, for a point, I kind of deviated from like sit down videos, which my channel is known for. Like, I'm here to give you like makeup reviews, hauls, and like, you know, this is what made me now. I do not like just start with vlogs. I know it's a part of thing and I know all people love it, so I do keep doing it, but what makes me happy is this, and I do want to get back to it, but I know if it's 2 months, kind of put a pause on it. So I kind of get the question also, like, maybe you're wondering like if I stop doing this, but no, this is something I will always do. But I do want to explore new things. I want to do more fashion content, more beauty, more lifestyle content, like different things I do want to explore. So I vlogged everything, like, while I was coming back, because I was so excited. I was like, I'll come home, my mom, my parents, everything. I'm like, I'll have home food, I'll hug Pravlika. This was like my main thing, you know, like to go see, hug my sister, like have home food and everything. And unfortunately, like the time I came back, my mom tested positive. It was already like 5 days. She never told us, but then I came and then my mom has this very normal thing. She has sinus issues. So like for her to get cold and severe cold is very, very common. So she was assuming that only. But then like the day I was coming, they were like, safer side, let's do a home test. And then it turned out positive, unfortunately. So I came home, I literally could not hug anybody. I could not eat at home for like 3 days. So it was already 5 days, right? So she stayed home like inside for 3 days, and she was taking like the hall, the bedroom and the kitchen, because like Pravlika does not stay in one place, and she's like, you cannot handle it, you just came in. So I had to kind of isolate in my room because they were roaming outside. So I was eating from outside only every day, and like I could not. The main thing, I was desperately wanting to come hug Pravlika, because she's like a stress buster for me always. Even at home, like I'm going from that room to this room, I'll irritate her in between, and I missed it so much the past 2 months. I wanted to like first come and hug her, and I could not do it. I had to like wait for 3-4 days, and I like eat so much shit outside, and it's like a whole thing. I was like, I did not even end that vlog or film after that, because it was like too much to take at home as well. Even if my mom realizes I'm telling it now, she'll scold me, but it's okay. I'm like, it's okay, people know you got it. But I don't know why these people have to keep it so secretive all the time. But yeah, like I came back the first week, I was so excited, and like everything was like, oops, you can't do anything now. And I was at like, you know, there inside. Then Navya, my friend's Guru Pravesh was there, and that day luckily I went out, and then from then it was back to normal, bitch. And also one more point is, you know, you kind of have this thing that people, like, you know, when they go to US, they get more progressive and stuff like that. And that is so far from true, I feel. Like, you know, there's this lady called Chinmay Sripadaya. She's like a Telugu or like South Indian kind of singer celebrity. So she used to post these screenshots about like guys in US and all. And I thought, like, how can people be like that? But honestly, I feel like It is true, you know, like if you as a person don't want to change your perspective, your beliefs, whatever it is, so even if it does not matter which part of the country or the world or anywhere you go, you will be the same. You will still be that same narrow-minded, patriarchal, misogynistic people. It's just too much. And me as a person, like also like among guys, I did feel like that, you know, there are guys who get just intimidated when a girl knows what she wants. And I'm not saying, like, I'm not praising myself for it, but I've experienced this a lot of times as well. When you're not so nice and, you know, jolly types, like, you know, very like how they expect a girl to be, they kind of take a step back and they assume naturally you are like, they just can't see that fact. Like, you know, anytime I say something, so there are different types of people, right? Some people, like, they just like don't care. Some people, they'll be like, you know, that's what he does, these are my beliefs, they just like, you know, listen and leave. They're like, his karma, he will do it. I'm not somebody who shuts up. I have a big mouth. If somebody says something, I will, like, you know, point out and like answer back or say something. I just don't keep quiet. I'll correct them or call them out right there. So I don't know if they're not used to it or they're not around the surroundings like that or what it is, but I also felt like there was this, oh my god, this one guy, like, you know, one guy, I faced it with multiple guys, but there was this one guy. You have this people, oh my god, I don't know how to explain. I was like so frustrated sometimes. It's like I'm talking to him and he'll talk to the other guy. I'm like, you have an issue, fucking talk to me. If I'm having a conversation with you, have a conversation with me. Why do you want to talk about that? Like, you know, that proper, extremely like sexist behavior. Like, you know, I'm not going to talk to you, I'll talk to the man. And like, it was that kind of behavior. And like, there's so many things like that linked to it. I'm like, oh my god, when I saw such things and like the way like the guys, you know, treated me or something like that as well. And all I met was guys. I did not get good girls, I did not meet like good girlfriends there. I mean, I gel up with girls like instantly, but with guys it comes with so much drama and I honestly cannot bear it. But most of the people I met were guys, and most of the people cannot, like, I cannot gel with, and I don't know if that they cannot gel with me, but you know, it always comes like a huge boundary with me for guys. I don't know why it is there that. And so when I see such people, I always was like, staying in India, we are so much better. Like, my entire friends group, like, I have so many friend gang, like, from college, from school, like, you know, 12th, like, here, friends and all. I'm like, we are so much more better staying in India. And I'm like, people around me, like, none of the guys think like that. None of the guys are like that. They're so progressive staying in India. And you guys are still like this. I'm like, it was like a, oh my, you know, such kind of mentality is just like too triggering for me. I'm like, oh my god, are you in the 1900s or are you like in 2000s? Like, you can't fucking talk to a female. Are you okay? Like, it's too much. Like, I if I start talking, like, I can say so many things, but I think this video is already pretty long. So we'll resume things in another video. So yeah, guys, that's it for the video, and that is what has been happening with me for the last 2-3 months. I have a lot more to say, but I think for this video I did say whatever I wanted to. If you like such videos, then let me know. I will make more such, like, but more in like story time things, like what happened where, like, you know, I was catcalled, I met a Karen, I met, like, I did so many things there. So I can, like, you know, make stories or general like story times in my general like life, day to life as well, because I can talk. I love sitting and just like sharing stories. I never did that on my platform because I did not feel like people are interested. But if you are, then let me know. Also, let me know what videos you want to see, if it's reviews, challenges, whatever it is, leave in the comments below. Again, if you want to get a shout out, then leave a comment with hashtag AKS and you might be, you know, in the video somewhere. So thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, then make sure you like, share, subscribe to my channel, give this video a thumbs up and leave a comment, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye. And generally, I'm a person, I spoil my friends. I do so much for my friends. My friends mean everything to me. I'm always very supportive. I'm always there for people. I'm at least hoping I am. My friends can judge about that, whether I am or not. But I feel I am. I'm quite good to my friends. So to see the opposite and for people to assume that I am a bad person. I just could not take it. Like, it was just a very weird space. Imagine, like, you just feel like a horrible person. And the feeling has kind of worsely carried on to me to home as well. Even now, I don't know how to deal with this. It's in my mind that am I just a horrible person? Like, you know, my people I'm good with, but others I'm... It just, you know, puts so much mental thing in your head, and I don't know how to figure out that yet, but it is, like, you know, kind of still there on my mind even if I'm home. But I just had to come home to feel safer and be in my bubble.